I'm just going to ask the questions that most people are interested.
I would be scared of something that I don't know as well. I wanted to be covered. I wanted that protection.
Protection from what? The typical thought process is if you're dressed like this, you're restricted, you're suppressed. Would you be okay with that, four wives?
No problem.
If you're in an airport, people are scared, right? Okay, wait, we got to stop on that for a second. What's the reaction?
I would like to be in a world that I did not have to cover. I would love Jewish friends.
Okay, Jewish friends out there.
Oh my goodness, I didn't know that was going to happen. I'm just starting to cry.
What would you have to say to those scared, people that are scared of women in niqabs? Good afternoon, guys. Quite often when a non-Muslim sees a woman in full cover, the niqab, there are curious thoughts, thoughts of the unknown, and sometimes even fear. So what not better a way to get into the mindset of a woman in a niqab than by talking to them? So that's what we're going to do right now. We're going to talk to a niqabi, a woman with a niqab, to get her perspective. Center of America. I missed the title. And Annette?
Hello.
Thank you for meeting up.
Sure.
Appreciate it.
Glad to meet you. Thank you for having me. Thank you.
Oh, well, our pleasure thank because so it's much. Not easy to speak with someone in a niqab.
Thank you.
Especially with a camera.
Yeah.
So, I'm just going to ask the questions that most people are interested. Most of my audience ask me when it comes to women and cover in Islam. The first would be, why? Why would you wear a niqabi? You have a choice, right?
Right. Yes, well, it started in 2017. I went to Iraq, and I went on the ziyarah of Imam Hussein, alayhi salam, and that's where it started to actually become that I decided to wear hijab as soon as I came back.
Okay.
From there.
Okay.
But before that, I was kind of like wearing my scarf already. And then I kind of, at cold times, I would put it over my nose and face. So those were little steps I noticed before.
It's been a process, step by step.
It's been a process. Through the travels, when I came back, I had a sense of emptiness and a sense of loss. Oh my goodness, I didn't know that was going to happen. I'm just starting to cry right now.
Oh, it's okay.
So I had emptiness and a loss.
What's up,
hello,
buddy?
Hello, sweetheart. Thank you for that. He's going to be regrouped. Okay, pulling it together.
He didn't even know
he pulled it together for me. But at times, I didn't know that this material, putting it back on and standing here and that, just mentioning him brought me right back to Iraq and the feeling that I felt when I left there, that emptiness. So I wanted to be covered.
Okay.
I wanted that protection. I wanted that feeling of that comfort.
Protection from what?
I wanted it to feel safe. I wanted to feel that safeness and comfort and ease and peace and that freedom of being there in Iraq that I felt. And I said, and I want to do that by wearing niqab. So on the Eid al-Zahra, alayhi salam, I said to Fatima, alayhi salam, I said, I want to wear niqab. And yep. I just put it on.
Look, the typical thought process is if you're dressed like this, you're restricted, you're suppressed. And I've been to Saudi Arabia, so I've talked to a few niqabis. And I've gotten different answers.
Right. Right.
What's your opinion on that?
Mine is the total opposite. Because, one, I'm Hispanic. I reverted to Islam. So I had that sense of not wearing a scarf. Maybe, I'm not answering for them, but I'm just saying maybe, because they never experienced the differences of it and how it made them feel.
So you dressed normally before?
Yes.
Normally as in
normally,
t-shirts?
Whatever's normal, yeah.
Yeah, whatever's normal.
T-shirts, tank tops, bathing suits, on the beach. No problem. I grew up in a Hispanic family, mm-hmm. Catholic.
That's interesting. You feel free. Is it because nobody can judge you?
Yes.
Like,
well, one thing, let me ask you.
Yeah.
Would you have known I'm Hispanic?
No.
No. Can you tell me how old I am?
No.
So can you tell me anything about me?
No.
No. So I look at everyone the same way now. But I didn't then.
Okay.
So I look at everyone as if I've known nothing about them, which I don't. I, even if they're wearing clothes or they're not, does not make that person better or worse. And surely does not make me better because I'm wearing full-blown chador right now,
mm-hmm.
and a niqab and hijab and everything. It does not make me any different than anyone else.
Right.
We just go through our own struggles in our own way. And I think the most for it was I didn't know who I was. I was trying to find it out through my life.
Mm-hmm.
And I believe that now I've come to the conclusion and the confirmation within myself and that self-peace.
Okay.
That I know who I am and I know what I believe in.
This helps with that?
Yes, it does. Because nothing else... I feel so different. I don't have to worry about what I'm wearing, what my hair looks like, bad hair day, and, you know, no makeup I want to, or dress, you know, up or down or whatever, however I feel.
So maybe there's less judging from the outside?
Yes. They said words can hurt, right? That young girls in this image that we're trying to portray nowadays, that words can hurt people because of what they think about what they're wearing or how mm-hmm. they look or their body size, or, you know, they don't fit in, they think they're overweight, they think they're underweight,
right.
They think so it's self-image, a lot of the things that we struggle with, and I did struggle with that. I was always too skinny, too, you know, too tall and
okay.
for myself, but I don't feel judged in that way, and I think a lot of that this went through was the evolving of me trying to identify who I am.
Mm-hmm. So you're saying nobody judges you, but
they okay, still judge. I know.
If you're in an airport,
yeah, they still judge.
People are scared, right?
Right. Yes.
Is that fair to say?
Yes. And that's what, another thing I was going to say. So in that, I'm comfortable within myself, right? But now, as I wear it, and when I came from Iraq, I didn't realize it's going to hit me like it did when I put the niqab on. My family had a hard time accepting it.
Right.
My friends had a hard time accepting it. Hold on. You were, and you did, you know, you never wore a scarf, and now
okay.
you're in the... So a lot of that still happens. I'm not going to say we can't eliminate it. However, it brings up the conversation, too, of the fact of, I said, you know, a lot of times people don't know. This guy, one time he was on, we were on a Facebook thing for work, and they posted a picture of me, and I wore a niqab for real estate, and... I don't know if you're keeping this or not.
Wait, for real estate.
For real estate. And he started to type to me in Arabic.
Tell me about real estate.
Yes, so I do real estate. And they posted a picture of me with my niqab.
Okay.
Welcoming me to the new company that I'm with. So he was like, yay, finally I get to use my Arabic link. You know, he started texting me in Arabic. I'm like, that's great. I'm like, now tell me what it says. I said, because I don't read Arabic. And I said, I can speak it. I said, but I can't read it.
You speak Arabic.
Yes.
Fantastic.
But I can't read it. So he started to laugh. He said, wait a minute. I said, because I'm Mexican.
Yeah, yeah.
And so it's like, so he sat here and I'm like, we are just going to take this out of the atmosphere here and,
right.
you know, leave it where it is. And everybody was so,
so
understanding of that. I just love it.
But you're doing real estate as
yes.
in showing homes? And so if you have a non-hijabi or niqabi client,
yeah.
you don't show up like this?
I wouldn't come in my full chador and my full, you know, I still have my niqab on, one. I'll have a niqab.
Niqab being this.
Niqab being the face veil.
So you're showing up to say, I'm coming to Dearborn to buy a home. Our first introduction, you're going to come in.
With my niqab, yes.
How do people react?
It's not up to me to determine how they're going to accept it. However, I will tell you that sometimes I do lighten it a lot for them because I can wear masks now. So, because of COVID. So it has broken some of those barriers where if it's uncomfortable for them, but one time, first of all, I like to show up in my niqab.
Okay. So you can get away with a mask. I guess the whole point is you can never show your face in public. Is that what it is?
Yes, I don't take pictures. You won't see me posting anything without my face veil on. And that was a hard thing for the companies that I'm dealing with. And also, even when I did actually do early childhood education as well.
Okay.
It's hard for the kids too, but it was a conversation piece.
Sure.
That because I was already teaching them and they... we're asking questions, why do you have to wear that now? And, you know, and it was a big transition for everyone. But it's a good conversation.
Right. So you can feel free because you're not being judged. You choose. I'm trusting that you're saying you choose to wear this. This is your 100% choice.
Right? Yes.
It's not a partner, a husband or anything that's choosing.
Most definitely not.
Okay. And you had many more choices. Mm-hmm. And you find freedom in the anonymity, let's say.
Yes. It's odd, but yes, because I wouldn't have thought of it, but the fact of the simplicity of it and not having to, like you're saying, you had it all, right? I've done things. Well, I haven't done everything, but you know what I mean? Everything was accessible to me.
What would you say to those women that think you're oppressed, you're held down, and you're not allowing yourself to be free?
Yeah, I would say I don't agree with that because I've never felt more free here in America, where it says the land of the free, home of the brave. I feel brave. I feel free.
A thing I've had a problem with. As an extrovert, one of the things, not a huge problem, but it's sort of something missing out of life, is 90% of our communication is nonverbal.
Right?
And so this, in a way, takes away the nonverbal.
Yeah.
I can see a little bit, through your eyes and whatnot.
Right.
But it's more of a mystery, let's say.
Yes.
Like how you feel about me or whomever, right?
Right.
I think that's probably... subconsciously one of the challenges people might have that aren't in your world.
Right.
I could imagine. Because honestly, the masks outside at distance.
Yeah.
Last winter, it was like you didn't get anyone's facial expressions.
Yes.
It was sort of hard. And
yes.
I'm trying to think through this thing.
Exactly. So it's hard to get into somebody's mind, right? It's hard to know what they're thinking, what they're saying, what they're speaking. But it's that wants you to be that mysteriousness that you're not knowing. So a lot of people couldn't understand me. They told me either I talk louder because they usually read my lips. If they couldn't understand, they'd look at your lips.
I said talk louder.
Or see my... Exactly. So talk louder or my facial expressions. If I'm smiling, I'm like, I have little wrinkles that are here.
Right.
You'll know if I'm smiling. And anyways, I left a party the other night and I told my friends we were taking these selfies. They're taking up their friend, you know, the whole party gang.
Okay.
And we were at a restaurant and I go out to, you know, birthday parties where it was a gathering at a restaurant, and she made accommodations that we were in the corner, so I was able to take down my niqab and eat in peace, you know. So it was really nice. And the thing is that when we were taking the picture afterwards, I told her, I was like, In the picture, I was smiling, by the way, and they all started laughing. So it's kind of like you can take the negative out of anything, or you can take the positive out of it. I've chosen to take the positive.
So to be fair, though, there are some women in niqabis that do not want to be in niqabis. Is this fair to say? Some don't.
I would say yes, and I would say there's even women that have wore scarves before that took their scarves off. I've I've known people who've done that as well.
Okay, so that's complicated. Like everything in the world, the more you go into a culture, a people, whatever, right?
Right.
Traditions, it gets complicated.
Yes, and
so
culture.
That's something I, you know, you can't put a label on it. The niqab is repression or freedom. However you want to spin it, it depends the person.
The person.
The conditions, the place, the family.
What they're comfortable with. Because again, I don't know if I said, but my family's Hispanic and they work, they're still Catholic. Mm-hmm. And I go to church if I can with them. And
you
I
go went, to church like
yes,
this?
Yes.
Catholic church?
With yes.
Like this?
Yes.
What's the reaction?
Well, they're really welcoming, actually.
Oh, that's
very
cool.
Welcoming. So, and also, I haven't been to, I told you before that I do practice the Sabbath, which is something that a lot of Muslims will, that they don't do, and they tell
do you,
a lot
you,
of.
Do you practice it with Jewish friends?
No, I have no Jewish friends.
Do you
I've
want,
met a few.
Do you want Jewish friends?
I would love Jewish friends.
Okay, Jewish friends out there.
I would love.
I did a series on the Hasidic Jews.
I saw that.
And many of the women said, we want to meet Muslim women.
There
so
you are. Please.
This is how the internet
that's
can work.
Exactly. Please.
In
yes.
favor of
yes,
everyone.
Yes,
yeah, practiced. There are a lot of commonalities, I got to say, between the Hasidic Jews and, say, your level of Islam. You practice salats, right? Five times
yes,
a day?
Yes, five times a day. And
At
night as well. Sometimes I wake up at 3:00 in the morning. I try to wake up in the middle of the night and do prayers as well, offer prayers.
Okay, we've ended up in the back of a parking lot. We've been instructed not to shoot the school. So
yes,
bear with us, audience. Trying to stay out of the wind. Trying to not cause any problems there.
You are a delight.
And we'll walk
Thank
back
so
this
much.
Way. So it's a parking lot tour, but it's about the content, not about the scenery so much.
Exactly.
It's beautiful up front, though.
It's a whole other topic, but four wives was hard. There's a lot of things in Islam that took me time to understand.
Okay, so would you be okay with that, four wives?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
So
I wouldn't be Muslim if I didn't get past that hurdle. So when
so,
I went
but,
through
but,
it...
Okay, wait, we got to stop on that for a second.
That's a whole other topic.
Because, okay, I want to be fair because,
sure.
Again, like,
even
so, every religion, people are going to have different ways of looking at things,
right,
and opinions.
Right, right.
So for you, if you're with a husband,
mm-hmm.
you're no longer with a husband. Is this correct?
Correct.
Okay. It would be okay if he had three other wives.
He couldn't handle two.
Yeah, that's true.
He did have
imagine.
Another one.
It seems
he did. He did. There was a situation that happened, and it's okay for you to film this because I'm totally fine with it.
Okay.
So, there was a situation that happened that we got divorced. He went ahead and we got divorced in American law, not Islamic law. There's a difference. So he got remarried and he came back, had a wedding, da 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 da. He comes back and then we had children together. So he decided that he wanted to still try to work things out with us, with me and him. And I said, but you're still married to your wife. You need, she needs to accept me. She didn't accept me. She was Muslim.
She was Muslim. He was from Iraq? He's from Iraq?
He was from Lebanon.
Lebanon. Okay. Mm-hmm. So, but some Muslim women are not going to be okay with...
Right. Well, that was just
three
proof
other
of it.
Three other wives.
Yeah, so
right?
That's proof of it. She
okay.
did not accept me.
Yeah.
I couldn't go through with it because if she does not accept me, it's not harmonious.
Okay,
how it should be.
Sorry to interrupt. So, guys, if you want to come to my videos for clarity, for you know, to unpack a concept, way of life, and make it easy to digest, this is probably it's the reality. It's the
yeah.
reality, right?
Yes. Yes.
I couldn't imagine having four wives.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm super happy with one wife, but like even two seems, apart from the infidelity, which I don't think is healthy,
but
it would be too much to manage.
Exactly. I agree with that. But I want to make this point.
Okay.
That the law was made for specific reasons like this. So he made a choice. We got a divorce. He made a choice. And he had regrets of that choice that he made. He had already got married to someone else. Now, should I say, okay, divorce her and come back to me? No, that would be bad on my end. So for me, it was hard. I'm not going to tell you it was easy, but it was hard for me to say, you know what, if I wanted to be represent Islam the best that I have, if I want to accept Islam, I have to accept everything that's written in there, and I have to do it the best that I can and be the best human being I could be.
How many daughters do you have?
Yes, I have three.
Three, and they all wear...
Well, no, actually, they don't all wear hijab. So they, one of them wears hijab, the older one, and it depends. Sometimes she's pinned properly. Sometimes it's kind of loose in the neck. Sometimes it's, you know, and then my other one did wear a scarf, but more because I like was pushing her to wear a scarf. She ended up taking it off. And then my other daughter...
You were pushing her to wear a scarf.
I was highly encouraging, I'd like to say. But I was
her freedom is not wearing it.
Her freedom is not wearing it.
And you respect that?
And I respect it. Okay. And I embrace her totally.
What would you have to say to those scared, people that are scared of women in niqabs?
I would be scared of something that I don't know as well. I didn't know anything about Islam or the language, Arabic language. I didn't know anything about anything, honestly. I'm still Mexican. I, you know, learned about this through my husband, and everything was new to me, everything I was scared of.
So you said reverted to Islam earlier. Mm-hmm. I didn't say anything. Mm-hmm. We talked about it off camera, but it was like, you were born Christian. Mm-hmm. By reverted, you meant you should have been born Muslim.
Yeah.
Is that what you meant? And then you came back into it?
I believe we're all born into submission, into Islam, and the purity of being born by God, because I believe that there is one God. So I believe all of us are connected through Him, and our parents are what make us either Catholic or Jewish or...
But that means I'm Muslim by birth?
I believe that to be totally honest with my words, yes. Sure. I would believe that, yes.
So would you like everyone to be covered? Like, from your perspective, since you're the minority of being covered, aren't covered.
I would like to be in a world, actually, to tell you the truth, I would like to be in a world that I did not have to cover. Because I would love to be in the country, and that's why I want to go to the country and have a house there.
Countryside,
poolside, lakeside, whatever, and be able to take off my scarf and feel at that place. And I do that sometimes in like the woodsy areas and stuff like that, just to kind of, but...
You'll go out there and take everything off?
Yeah,
not everything, but okay.
But my scarf, I'll take my scarf off, or I'll you know, loosen it at least, or I'll have some more. And it's more of a comfort within myself, because I grew up in the country, and I love that feeling that's there, and just like the wind in your hair. And
sure.
Like right now, the wind's in my scarf, but I mean, just a comforting feeling. But I would love to be in a world that we don't have to, because we respect each other's boundaries. We respect each other as humanity as a whole.
So any final words? What would you want to tell people that have questions about women in niqabi? Should they speak to them? I've tried, some women will speak to me and some won't.
Right.
My time in Saudi Arabia, I think the default was do not approach at all.
Right.
And if you're introduced or something, you can speak.
Right.
Is that sort of what it means too? Like, don't
It's just like
come into my world?
Somebody, I would say, like anybody.
Okay.
Anybody in general. Sometimes there are people that you can approach, and there's some people that are standoffish, that introverted, that they don't want to speak to anyone. Some people that might have biases as far as cameras and stuff, which
sure.
I'm really, you know.
Well, I think you're the only one of the few women in a niqab that would do this.
Uh-huh. Really?
Don't you think?
I don't know about that. But, I mean, I'm definitely more outgoing because of, I think, the lifestyle that I've had, and I'm more open maybe to have these conversations, because I think I've been through a lot of the pain and the struggle that it took me to get there, that I'm kind of like saying that I'm here, I'm good, and I'm happy, and I'm growing as an individual. As far as Islamically, I feel like I'm very strong in my religion and my faith.
Sure.
And I'm so strong in it that I would like love to go, and I love the place that you chose because it's got a church over them that side.
Yeah.
And there's another church there.
Over there.
So it's like
Orthodox.
I loved the positioning of this mosque when it was built.
Yeah.
Because I would love to go, and like I said, I go to the church if I can. If I would be invited to a temple, anybody, I would love to definitely go there and in
but
the
that's
Jewish
not
temple,
nor- that's but not normal.
It's
you're
not
open,
a normal,
you're open
yeah.
minded.
I would
to
be
other
open
places.
Minded to go to definitely to different places, and I think the fact that I'm comfortable in myself now, I think I'm able to talk about it. Maybe before
okay.
I wasn't.
Okay. So, thank you.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
Just to let you guys know, Annette's a very brave soul and very open for her, you know, willing to be on camera and take these questions. It's not a normal thing, I would say, for a woman in a niqab to be able to talk to me on camera.
Right.
So we have to thank her for letting us into her world, letting us into your world, because that's
you.
The only way we learn and see
right.
somebody's perspective
right.
and understand things better.
And I must thank you for doing what you do, because like I said, you took me into other worlds that I wouldn't have been able to see, and that was one of the reasons that I decided to do this with you. So
yeah, we connected because Annette saw the Hasidic Jew series.
Yes.
The Hasidic Jewish series, and I think you saw the
Amish
woman
now too. Yes,
the
there
Amish,
was a
yeah.
woman.
Yeah.
Yes, there was a woman.
Malki.
Yeah. So if anybody wants to invite me to the countryside and the Amish to learn about that, I would love that as well.
That would be a great video.
Yes. Oh yes. Oh,
what if I did this video? I put you with my buddy Kashmir from the hood.
Totally.
With my buddy
what hood
Shlomi,
are you talking about? No,
East,
I was from
East,
Southwest
East New York.
Okay.
East New York.
Okay, I could go there. Okay.
My Hasidic friend Shlomi.
Okay.
And then one of my Amish friends.
Okay.
And we go to Amish country.
There
How about
we go.
That sounds
amazing. Okay. I'm there. I'm packy.
All right, guys. Hope that answers some of the questions.
Thank you so much.
Thanks for coming along. Until the next one.